शेयर किया क्या? मैं शेयर नहीं कर रही ना व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप
नहीं कर रही। Kindly occupy the front seats over here. Everyone sitting on the back. Also, please maintain all the COVID protocols. Keep the masks on. So, good afternoon, everyone. I would like to request Dr. A.B. Dada sir to welcome the guest speaker, Avani Pattanga ma'am. I would also request Dada sir to felicitate and welcome Jay Chandran sir. So Avani ma'am is Vice President of Learning and Development in Global Talent Track GTD and L&D professional with 17 plus years of rich and insight experience in the telecom, BFSI, BPO, IT, ITES industry. She has pursued BA in psychology from Garhwal University, Dehradun, bachelor's in journalism and mass communication from JIMS, master's in mass communication from Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, Delhi, MBA in human resource and marketing from Four School of Management, New Delhi, and diploma in training and development from Indian Society of Training and Development. She was lead voice and accent trainer in IBM for 2 years. Training resource Intel Perot System, AM grade in WNS Global Services, training and development in NIIT, corporate trainer, P&D and soft skills trainer in Infosys for 4 years, manager in Altametrics for 4 years, chief training consultant in Genpact, India training manager in Taste Proper Incorporation, senior training manager in Reliance Jio for 2 years, AVP leadership, learning and talent in Barclays for 2 years. Avani ma'am is extremely passionate about her training work. So I would like to request her to take over from here. Thank you.
Question to ask, because I could already see the energy that was already created in the morning, right? Yes. How was the session so far? All good? Yes. Okay, so I have my colleague Jay Chandrana, who also has a lot of experience in L&D. He carries more than 15 years of experience in learning and development primarily. And in fact, you know, we were just having a nice cup of chai with sir, and that is when, you know, Jay was also mentioning that he has already come here in Wadia College, right? And you have trained on...
I've come for campus equipment score at one of the engineering colleges.
Right. Great. So what we're going to do is, before we get started, right, we want to ask a few questions, right? First of all, what was the first session all about and what did you learn from that session when ma'am was speaking? Sorry, business communication. Okay. Okay. Anybody else?
How to deal with people.
Okay. How to deal with people. What else?
Etiquette.
Okay. Okay. That's great. Anybody else who wants to answer?
just feel free to answer and talk, right? Any language is okay, English, Hindi, Marathi, or any other language that we can understand, of course. We have to have a session on goal setting, but before we actually get into goal setting, or maybe after we've done a little bit of goal setting, we can get into some more of communication aspect, right? Because it's all interrelated, isn't it? It's not separate, it's not divided, it's all very interrelated, right? Okay, just to get an idea from all of you, to know more of each one of you, which is not possible because there's so many of you, right? But anybody who is not from Pune or Bombay can raise their hands. Yeah, so a lot of you. Okay, can some of you give the cities that you come from? Yes, yes, please go ahead.
Kolhapur.
Kolhapur. Okay. Akola. Okay. Jalgaon. Satara. Sangli. Sholapur. Parbhani. Okay, anybody outside of Maharashtra?
Yes, we have, but students are online in that.
Oh, okay. Students are online. Are they attending online?
Yeah, we have a live YouTube.
Okay, it's like a hybrid session.
Yeah.
So I hope they can hear.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And okay, so hi to the students who are online as well, right? Some of them, can they unmute themselves and speak?
No, we do.
Not really. Okay. Okay, no problem. Just wanted to understand if there are any students out of Maharashtra. So I understand they may not have been able to travel. Oh. All right. So very quickly, are you all interested in a game? Yes. Okay. Since we have a lot of students and we have very limited time, how much time do we have? About an hour.
Yes.
Yes, about an hour. Okay. So it's a very important game and a very interesting game, right? Now for that, I need one volunteer. And if I could have a, come, please come. And if I could have a pen and paper. And I'll request all of you also to take out your pen and paper if possible. We'll do a little pen and paper activity. You would not really need it. You don't really need it. You can come here. If I could just. Make this interesting, right? What I'll do is, let's just for the sake of it, call this part of the hall team A, is that okay? And this part of the hall team B, right? Now what I'm going to do is something very interesting. I'm going to draw something, okay? And what I'm going to do is now this is a competition, okay? If we had more time, we could have played more rounds, but what we're going to do is, I'm going to put a very simple drawing, okay? And what's your name, sorry?
Abhiraj.
Abhiraj. Abhiraj, you're from which place?
Pune.
Which part of Pune?
Aum.
I was in Aum last evening at Western Mall. Yeah, so I'm just trying to build my connection there. Any idea about Rapo building? Ever heard of Rapo building? Yeah? So that's a good idea, you know, to start your Rapo building. Have you heard of small talk? Okay, thank you so much. Small talk? Okay, what is small talk? Any idea? I'm sorry, I'm deviating from the topic, but because we introduced and I just spoke with him, I thought I'll bring that topic in. What is small talk? Any idea? Sorry? Yes, no question type? Okay, all right.
The conversation you have with the person to know him, the okay. Initial judgment you need.
Okay. Sorry?
Break the ice,
absolutely, very right. Any other answers? Just feel free to, give a response. No answer is wrong in a training session. Yes? In a training session conducted by Avni and Jay, no answer is wrong. Okay, so just feel free to, yes? Okay, limited conversation. Okay, what's your name? Sneha. Okay. Snehal. Thank you, Snehal. What was your name you replied?
Sameer, okay. Thank you, Sameer, also for your response. Anybody else?
To know each other.
And what's your name?
Rohan.
Okay, very quickly. So, you know, I understand you are sort of now entering a phase where you're going to be studying, hopefully not in online mode, but we don't know, right? We don't know yet. It all depends. But if tomorrow when you're actually going into the corporate world and working, right, have you heard of or read of these water cooler conversations or coffee machine conversations?
Yes.
Yes. What is the kind of conversation that happens at these places?
Gossip.
I was just about to say that. Gossip. Okay. But what if you have to really break the ice, like someone said here from team A? Sorry, team A, B, I forgot. Yeah. So if somebody has to break the ice, you understand breaking the ice? Yes. So for example, I've just joined Global Talent Track, right? And Jay is my manager, right? I have to really go ahead and ensure that I have a good rapport with him, right? What do I do? How do I break the ice? Saying hello, okay, yes. Okay. Okay, so not really a role play, but what did we just do?
Making a connection.
Because I was actually around yesterday in Western Mall. So, you know, right there. And maybe Raviraj wants to continue with the conversation. He can ask, oh, really? What were you doing in Western Mall? Or do you stay in Aum? Right? And I would say, no, I stay in Bimarnagar. Okay, so what were you doing in Aum? So you see the kind of conversation that starts happening? We could be office colleagues and yet have that conversation, right? So that's going into the small talk of it. Right? That is known as small talk. We are trying to build a connection. We are trying to build a rapport with somebody. And then your eventual goal could be, you know, possibly could be that you are trying to get some work done. Yes? Not in the wrong way, right? But you're attempting to get some work done. For example, if Jay is my manager, I want to get my leaves approved. What do I do? Should I have that rapport with my manager? No. Okay, somebody says no. I will not name those people. Anyway, I don't remember or know your names. So what do I do? Do you think having a rapport with somebody, whether it's college or office later on in life, having a rapport helps? Yes. How does it help? For example, in getting leaves approved from my manager? Yes, no, maybe?
Yes.
Helps? Right? Okay. What else can it help in? Okay. Okay. All right. Thank you. What's your name? Rujul. Okay. Thank you, Rujul. Yes. Anybody from? Yes, you're very right, my friend. What's your name?
Sandesh.
Sandesh. Okay, Sandesh, you gave a very right Sandesh. Right? You will have a priority over others. Right? So, for example, if Jay and I have a good rapport with each other, right? Firstly, we will be working towards a common goal and it will be easier. Having a better rapport also means that if there is a goal that we have as a team, it will be easier to achieve that, right? If you talk about goal setting, right? The communication between the two of us will be smoother, right? And have you heard of this phrase called being on the same page?
Yes.
Yeah, so rapport building is also a lot to do with being on the same page, understanding each other as team members, at least when it comes to professional life. Personally, he may have different choices, I may have different choices. Personally, on a personal front, we may do very different things, which is okay. Right? But having that rapport is very important. That's where small talk comes into the picture. Okay, a very quick question before we actually start with the game. Sorry, I'm making you wait. Okay, any idea what is like the number one topic or number two topic that is usually taken up in small talk? Weather. Who said that? What's your name?
Sachin.
Good side. Yes. Anybody else? Politics. Okay. What's your name? Ganesh, okay, all right. Office work, okay, all right. Yes, that could be a good, so for example, if Jay and I are from different teams, Jay is from operations and I am from training, right? Mm-hmm. Then I could possibly go and start talking something related to office work,
yes,
to build that better rapport with, you know, maybe I could start talking about office timings. Maybe I could start talking about some work that we have done in the past together. Anything else? How was your day? Absolutely.
Hobbies.
Okay.
Transportation and self-care to office.
Absolutely. Very good. What's your name?
Samir.
I'm sorry. Very good, Samir. Yes. So weather, transport and connectivity. How was your day? Right? Are you standing at the coffee machine? How do you like this coffee? Or do you like coffee or not? No, I'm more of a chai person. No, I'm a coffee person. You understand? And then the next time when you see that person, do you think that person will say hi to you in the office?
Yes. Definitely, right?
Because you've already introduced each other. Even if it was just... So, for example, for the last 2 days, you know, I was not going to the office. I was not very well. But today when I went to the office, after a good gap of 4-5 days, I met quite a few people in the morning who actually... instead of saying good morning, they said Happy New Year.
Yes.
So don't you think that's also a good way of building rapport? And if, for example, I'm not known who the people are, at least the next time I'll see them, I'll say hi myself.
Yes.
Right? Because they wished Happy New Year. Right? And if not that, in a general, you know, conversation, just saying hi, wishing good morning also leads to building those connections. Right? Okay, we spoke about connections. We spoke about rapport building, small talk, and all of that is related to goal setting also, and Jay will take it forward, but before that we'll do a game. Okay, now in this game I'm going to draw a very simple figure, some drawing I'll draw. Okay, now what you have to do is, now this is for you and for your team, okay, what you have to do is you have to ensure that your goal is that with a span of 3 minutes your team should be able to draw exactly the same figure. You cannot show it to them. I'll show it to you guys because you're a different team. Okay? So that's how we play the game. Now, there are very specific rules for both of you. Right? You can only take the names of or give the directions like draw a parallel line, draw a vertical line, draw a horizontal line, and you cannot do actions with your hands. Otherwise, if you're doing those actions with your hands, your team will understand what has to be drawn. The same applies for all of you because you are his team. Right? You will not be able to ask him questions like that. Right? You cannot take the name of shapes. You cannot say draw a rectangle, square, circle. Okay? And you cannot give out the name of the object, of course. Whatever is drawn here. Okay? You cannot...
Can be the reference.
No. No references. So it's just plain and simple lines. Draw because the bottom right hand corner. So you know what is the bottom right hand corner, left hand, top right, top left, etc. You tell them, okay, you've drawn a horizontal line, you draw another line. So I have a simple one. Yes. We'll 3 minutes. Okay, so I'm giving you a very simple one. Are you all ready?
Yeah.
So you can take this. Remember, you don't have to go to this. You can take about 10 seconds to see how you want to explain it to your team. Okay, and then come to what we're doing and why. Okay, are you ready? Okay.
English.
Because then you will not understand it. Okay. Okay, you want to give out the name of the object. So you are also giving the name of the object. Yeah. So I'll draw the one.
So no shapes, no objects, no.
I just said no, no, only lines.
Okay.
Okay, so just to let you know, I was slightly invisible, this one I draw. You all would have been able to draw it in less than a minute.
Small line, top of the page.
You can also try it.
Draw a line connecting to that line. Vertical line. Vertical line. Sorry? Downward. Any angle. Both ends. Draw parallel line to it, connecting the other end. Leaving some gap, middle bottom of the page, draw another horizontal line, small.
You want to stop this presentation right now? We can do
bottom,
we can do that.
Line,
right?
Same. Okay. Parallel to the upper line.
Okay, I've just sent him to take a picture actually.
Mirror image. Keep some gap between the two pole-like things. Draw a point in between the gap ahead. That's from the point back. Sorry.
So if you want to guess, you can guess. If you are able to guess what the object is, it's fine. He cannot say.
Draw small indicator type lines indicating the directions in between the two objects around that point.
Okay, that is also not allowed, so avoid saying that. Because then you're giving out a hint of what the object does.
Okay.
Okay, no problem. Let's go ahead. Okay, good try. Good try. But not a
you have drawn the second part like the first part, right?
Yes.
Okay. Close, yes, sir.
You can go on, you
watch.
Have more than watch.
Okay,
who has drawn a watch?
No.
But you have to.
No.
Did he do something?
No.
Okay, very good. That's a watch. That's a watch. Yeah. It's okay. Okay, so can you see this? I'm not very clear because of pencil drawing. Yes? Watch. Okay, let's clap for Abhiraj. We need another volunteer from here. A volunteer from here. Come, Rujul, right?
Yes.
go back. Thank you. Okay, so now they are going to do the same thing. I hope you know the know and remember the rules. Yes, only shapes and not taking the name or any similar looking object or the function of what. Oh yeah. Okay, I'm trying to think. Very simple thing. Yeah. So even if you're able to get the basic thing, it's right. Okay. Okay, ready? Team A actually, right? Okay.
Another parallel line with the same vertex line. Left side, bottom corner. I want a line that goes in a direction, a circular direction.
Or circle is a shape, so avoid that.
Ma'am, can I do a function of a certain?
No.
Okay. A curve, a line.
Now you join the
other parallel. Same thing, upside. Again, to the top corner, the top figure. Draw a line just below it. The one that you've drawn right now, to the top corner, top side.
Avoid using my hand. You can keep your hand on the back.
Okay. Yeah, yes. A line from the top right corner to the bottom corner. A line which joins the right side parallel line that is drawn, connect the top to the bottom. Top corner, the right side top corner that you have of the vertical line which is present to the right side, join that to the bottom corner, bottom right corner of the curve that you've drawn below it. The line that you've drawn below to join the two parallel lines, just connect to the right corner of that line, just connect the top one line.
Are you all right?
No.
What if you win again?
This man is not able to
do it. What if they can't do it and you all can do it?
It's a cup.
Okay? Okay, that's good. Let's clap for her. Good. As you can see, yes,
very good.
Yeah, okay, let's clap for this team. Thank you. Okay, now why did we do this game? Why did we play this game? Or what did you learn from? Sorry, we're on the same page, absolutely. Okay, what else? Coordination. Very good. Proper direction and guidance, which was given by Rujul and there Abhiraj. Okay.
And listening and analyzing skills.
Listening and?
Analyzing.
Listening and analyzing skills. Okay. Very good. Sorry? Imagination skills, very important for creativity. Expressing beyond limitations. Okay. What else? Okay, in the interest of time, I'll wrap it up here. But whatever you said, do you think it relates to goal setting?
Yeah.
So if you have a goal, you have to be imaginative. Yes, you have to be creative. You have to go beyond your limits, right? To have a goal and to be able to implement it, right? You should have listening and analyzing skills, right? Communication skills, right? Another very important element, something that we can learn from this is, have you observed that you're trying to give directions to somebody on the phone and that person doesn't understand the directions to reach? Happens?
Yes.
Why does that happen? Because when we are trying to say something and the other person is understanding something else completely, that's where there is a gap. Isn't it? There is a gap in communication. Right, so I'm sure you, I don't have that picture handy, but there's a picture that went famous for a very long time where
there's a coder or an engineer or a designer who designs and they say, this is what the client wants and this is what we have done. It's a swing, right? So I'm sorry, I don't have that picture. Otherwise, I would have shown it to you. Maybe we can share it with you later. We'll have Vincent or someone share it with you. So there's a huge gap between what was expected and what eventually done. To bridge that gap, you know, it's important to ensure that whatever somebody else is saying, we understand and we are on the same page so that we are able to reach our goals. Yes? Okay, so Jay, over to you.
All right, can you hear me?
Yes.
Am I loud enough?
Yes.
Thank you, I don't know what to use. Okay, so what I'd like you to do is again start up with a quick activity. You all have your pens and books ready. I just walked around and took a look at it. I'd like you to quickly, in the next 1 minute, write down 10 of your goals of your lifetime. I know it's just the beginning of life for most of you here, but think of 10 things that you want to achieve in your entire lifetime and write down. What is something that you want to buy, something that you want to invest in, you're already thinking of investing. I'm sure your parents must have told you to, invest in a property, vehicle, whatever you want to write. 10 things. A good girlfriend, good boyfriend, good husband, good wife is also fine. You can jot it down. Okay, that's it, time up. That's okay, how many of you will do that, right? Okay. Now, what we'll do is, now look at it again. I walked around and saw a few of you writing very beautiful things, very interesting, which we will probably talk about a little later. Now, what you can do is, strike out, cancel 5 of it from that list. Cancel 5, wait. Cancel 5 of them, which you think is okay not to do. I'll give you one example of him, your name?
Sachin.
Sachin has written this one point, very interesting point, which is okay if he doesn't do. Okay, he's written this point of being part of multiple companies. So do you mean own multiple companies or switch jobs?
Own.
Okay, so he wants to own multiple companies. Okay, it's a goal, but it's okay if you own one, right? It's not that you will not survive if you don't own multiple. So similarly, you can think of few points that you can strike off. Go ahead. 10 seconds. You have only 4 or 5. What would you try? That's why I said make it 10. Make it 10. Done? You don't have a question of what? Okay, so that's what I'm talking about on this particular slide over here, the importance of goals, right? So you all jotted down plenty of points, but then when I gave you the second part, you saw the importance of what is really needed, what is not needed. For example, Sachin struck out everything except 1 point. He had only 5 or 6 points already. He struck out all of them except one. So now he knows that that is the most important thing he wants. Yeah. Please let me know if I'm going fast. If I'm talking fast, I know I do talk fast, but let me know. You can raise your hand anytime and show me down. That's fine. Yeah. How many of us in this room do not? How many of us in the room do not understand English? No one? Great. How many of you do not understand Hindi? Great. So I'm going to talk Hindi-English mix. I don't understand Marathi. I don't talk Marathi. I only understand Marathi when you talk bad about me. That time I definitely understand Marathi. Okay. Otherwise, I don't understand. Okay. So let's move on. So let's see. During the session, we're going to look at these points. So how important is goal setting? Understanding the types of goals that we have. Know the myths around goal setting. There are some myths, some negativity, or some thoughts that are not true. Mm-hmm. And know how to create a work-life balance based on well-set goals. So your work-life balance, you can also relate to your education-life balance, because you have 2 more years of education, right? So you can relate it to that. Okay, so many people here feel as if they worked hard. I remember the madam in the morning who was here, she mentioned a couple of times that work hard, work smart. And she also spoke about the aggregation of smart. But they don't seem to be anywhere worthwhile. They work hard a lot and don't seem to get anywhere. Your goals are always time bound, idea bound, and motivation bound. Okay, now I just picked up Sachin's name and I said he would really want multiple companies. He's self-motivated already that he wants to multiple companies. But what I thought when I read that line over there, I thought he wants to switch multiple jobs. That was his goal. And that was scary because then a lot of companies that you have attrition in a lot of companies. Right? So that's scary. And that's why I put on that point. But then he made me understand that he wants to own many companies. It's different. Okay. So he wants to own many companies. It's different. Okay. So time bound. Set a time for your goal. So go ahead. The points that you mentioned over there, how many were? Let's do both. Let's do the strike ones also. If you cancel those, still, let's keep them back. And let's put a timer there. Next to the point, put a time anywhere between 3 years. I'm saying 3 years because you start working 2 years later, right? So between 3 years and 10 years, put a time there. Put the number of years you want to take to achieve that. Okay, so if you are written on iPhone, you can buy within a year of starting your job if you really have that motivation for an iPhone. But if you've written an SUV, somebody I saw over here, SUV, SUV, you can write 4 years, 5 years, depending on because obviously you start off your career up 2 years and depends what kind of package you join in. Unless you already have a lot of savings.
for me, for my knees and all that. Put a time over there. Number of years, anywhere between 3 years to 10 years. Done. Why have I made you do this? Why did I make you put the number of years there? Just because time is mentioned here? No. No. Do we know what is a vision attraction? Anyone heard of it? What?
What you imagine. Okay, that's one thing. Anything else?
Absolutely. Very nice. Yeah, so what you desire, of course, that imagine, and what you see every day. How many of us have watched the movie called Wake Up Sid? Ranbir Kapoor. Who's not seen the movie? Please watch it. can someone tell me what am I getting at? Why am I saying Wake Up Sid movie? Huh? He had no vision, but he had something there. For? No. Something else. Remember, think of the movie. Yeah, he had passion for photography, of course, yes, but what say vision, what am I trying to link it to? So many of you have watched the movie. He had passion for what else? Huh? No. He didn't have the passion to go to
his dad.
Anyone?
Huh? For his mother?
No, no, no. Anything? Think of the movie. No. No. Okay, let me give you a hint. Something to do with this laptop. No. Well, people are thinking now. Toughest thing to do in the world. Think. What else? Okay, let me give you another hint. Something to do with his dad's office. Huh? No. Something to do with vision, with thinking, with his laptop, with his dad's office. Come on. No, planning what? Blank? Okay, let me remind you. Did you all see, by any chance, you remember seeing he looking at his laptop at the dining table and his dad offers him to join the business? Correct. Why does his dad do that? Car. Thank you very much. Okay, he wanted a Porsche. Porsche is a brand of the car that he wanted, a very expensive car. And what he was doing, he had the screensaver on his laptop, on his desktop, with a Porsche. His dad said, come work for 30 days and I'll get you this car. He went to office for just 3 days or 2 days, something like that. And he kept looking at the car. If you remember the movie, go back and watch it otherwise. Yeah, he kept looking at that car because he really wanted it. Eventually, he ran away. He gave up. But that was his motivation, his dedication for that thing, the goal. You know, his dad offered him to work for 1 month and you get him the car, but he didn't eventually. That's second thing. We can have another friend. Sorry. I have another friend. In fact, my old colleague in my previous company where I was working, this person was a freelance trainer. He's still a freelance trainer. And I have gone to his house for dinner. Okay, I gone to his house for dinner at Bhavdan. And while having dinner, obviously, we were, you know, having a drink as well and stuff like that, and I wanted to use the washroom. So I asked him, where can I go? He said, go to my bedroom. I said, take it. I went and I came out of the washroom, but I wanted to still stand in that bedroom and look at something. He had put a vision board. He had put a paper, KG cardboard, what you call trap paper, and he had written the number of years and a particular figure at every year and every month, actually, yeah, month wise as well. He had put an amount over there, some figure. He came there and I asked him, I said, what is this? Explain to me. He said, nothing. I put it over here because when I wake up in the morning, I want to see that first. That's the amount I want to achieve in the next 3 years, four years, something like that. And it was in crores. The figures he had put was in crores, like starting with thousands, lakhs, and then crores. And you know what? About 2 years later, we met again, generally, and he had achieved it. I think about 4 crores. Yeah. He wanted to have a savings of 4 crores within that span of time. And he did it because it was visionary. He was visionary. And he kept looking at that every day. That motivated him to increase the amount every time. Right? Of course, you get selfish also then. Okay, so we look at goal setting over here. It is used for successful business people. So MBA, if you're looking at starting your business or owning companies, motivation. That's your goal setting. Okay. It gives you long-term vision and short-term motivation, like we did, number of years, 3 years to 10 years. What do you want within 3 years? What do you want within 10 years? Like I told you that you'll start earning, obviously, 2 years later, once you join your jobs or start your business or whatever. It's even possible that you start saving from your pocket money or any kind of income that you have right now, from now itself, to achieve what you've written down. Okay. In fact, you can do one more thing. The paper that you've written in, you can tear that and stick it somewhere in your house, in your rooms where you're staying. Look at it every day. Okay. Focus on accumulation of knowledge and helps organize time and resources, etc. Setting sharp, clear, defined goals. So we've already set clear, defined goals. Right? So you define what you want. And like I was walking around and I saw people writing like lines and lines. That's when I said you can just write one word. But that's nicely defined. You've written it as a complete line. It helps progress forward. That's what I said, that if you want to progress forward, you stick it somewhere and look at it every day and get self-motivated. And it gives you self-confidence and self-motivation. Let's move on. Why do we need goals? Here you go. Target-oriented behavior. Setting goals affects outcomes in 4 ways. Let's look at the 4 ways. It's your choice, effort, your persistence, and the reason for the particular goal. Okay, so these are the goal outcomes that we'll look at. I will go through this. It's quite self-explanatory, but it's okay. I'll skip to something interesting. Right. So we have a Harvard case study. Let's look at this case study. It's quite interesting. Okay, so she says, this image over here, I call it she, says, I have written goals and plans. Okay, these are people who graduated, written goals and plans. I have not written goals down, no goals at all. So this was a survey done many years ago for people, for a bunch of people. 3% of the people said we have written goals. 13% said they have not written goals. I have goals but not written down, and no goals at all. Okay, that's 84%. That's quite a big number for people saying not written, no goals at all. I'll just go as life takes me around. Ten years later, the same bunch of people were interviewed again, were surveyed again. Okay, you can Google this as well. This is available. 84% of the goals, 84% of people who had no goals at all were earning average. 13% who had goals on an average, but they were earning twice as much of the 84% crowd. So they were earning a little better, who had goals but not written down. And the 3% who had clear written goals were earning on average 10 times as much as the remaining. 10 times more than the remaining 97% of the people. So in spite of such proof of success, most people don't have clear, measurable, time-bound goals. Like we mentioned, the SMART abbreviation, that you need to set your goals in a SMART manner. Measurable, time-bound. We've already put a time for your goal, so you have a time-bound goal there. And it's clear what you want. Okay, so that was the entire survey. So when you talk about goal settings, you have individual goals, which you've already written down right now, right? You have something called as team goals. Team would be, you can either have your team goals right now, as in while you start your education, your classes, you can have a team goal. Or that would lead to a project goal anyways, because if you're a team, you'll probably work on a project together. So you'll have a project goal, and then you have company goals or your education goals, whichever. But company goals eventually, yes, because 2 years down the line, your own organizations or you work somewhere, so that would be a company goal. Same thing that we spoke about. Myths of goal settings. People think this way, but it's not true. So we often hear many things about how to go about setting goals, and some. Let's look at some myths of setting the goal. Myth number one: just do it. We must understand that just doing will be able to get results. Setting, planning, and doing true action plan produces actual results. So you plan it and do it, just not do it, produces actual results. So you plan it and do it, just not do it, just not say just do it, that is 90s tagline, but you plan and do it. Okay. All goals must be time-bound. So we've already discussed this multiple times, that all goals must be time-bound. Although it is important to have a time-bound goal, there are times when some goals need to be realigned. So you may have a change in your goal. Okay, if you've written down that I want to buy an i10 car, and you end up buying, eventually you end up buying an SUV. So that can be changed. Okay, so not necessarily that your goal remains the same. Goal setting is a logic-based activity. Well, only the planning of goal is a logic-based activity. Emotions play a very important role. How many of us have written something to do? Please raise your hand. How many of us have written about something to do with family members? Emotion-based. Right? So if I say I want to take my mother for a world tour, or at least I want to, you know, take her for an India tour, that's an emotion-based thing. So it's not only logical, always it can be emotional as well. Goals should be fixed is what it says. But as time passes, your goals can change. It's not necessary that it has to be fixed. Okay, you must have written 3 years, 5 years or whatever. That can be definitely changed. It can either be earlier or it can extend time, whichever. Okay, some of the reasons that we have, why we set goals. If someone asked you to sell devotion with them, the image would come to mind. What is the purpose of my direction? What if they ask me to sail to Africa within 90 days and do a safari? So that's a goal again. Okay. Next one, it talks about the difference between goals, and the latter one creates clear sense of purpose and direction. It is more likely to spur action, it talks about, and a well-stated goal provides a sense of meaning, purpose, and direction. We've done that all just now. Sorry, something's wrong. Right, you have some types of goals. What are types of goals? We already wrote a few things down over here, long-term or passive goals. So it can just be a goal that is kept and not worked upon as of now. It's a long-term goal. That's why that time I thought he wrote 50 years, but it was not 50 years. Okay, so he wanted to be fit till the age of 50 is what he meant, long term. Short term or active, short term, you start working quickly. The example I gave you that I want to buy an iPhone within 1 year, I'll start working very quickly. I know the iPhone will cost me almost a lakh. I can start saving at least 10,000 every month. Within a year, I'll have that. Say similar thing, you have passive goals and active goals. We spoke about this. Your direction of how you want to do it is what it tells you. Benefits of goal settings. So future orientation rather than past failures. So you look at the benefit in future and don't think about the past, that oh, it did not happen. What will happen? You know, don't stay in the past always. Career planning via creating a progress track, clarity of your goal setting and a commitment. Commitment that I want to achieve it. Right? So plan, this is what it says. Plan it up appropriately, prioritize it. See what you want to prioritize. Now, for example, you have this list that you've made. See what you want to do first and what you want to do later. You can even number that. Right? Your fourth or fifth point may be your priority that you want to do it the first. You can number it, prioritize it. Prioritize as in make it the most important thing first. The most passionate thing first. And then the other thing can follow. So planning and prioritizing is very, very important for your goal setting. If you do not plan or prioritize it, it just fizzles away. So it's goes away. Right? Any questions, anyone? Yes, no? You know what it means, no? If you don't have any questions, what does it mean? There are two things to it. Say yes, my thing. Absolutely. Either you understood everything or understood nothing. So which one are you going with? First one, second one? Yeah, say it because I'm saying, no? First one. Any questions, anyone? Both of us can answer any of your questions if you have any.
But have you achieved your goals?
Oh, thank you, Alex. Yes, so I am working on it. I have achieved a couple of goals that I had written down. From my college time to my first organization where I worked. Obviously, even I was a participant for a goal setting session for the first time when I started working. So yes, I have done the same thing. I have written things down. I have stuck it up on the wall. Even mobile phone is a good idea to do it. And one of my goals is pending for this year. This year end, I have one major goal that I want to achieve. I want to buy an SUV, which I'm looking at to pick up by this year end. So that's one of my goals. I have never had a goal of buying property. A lot of people want to buy property, but I'm not very keen to buy a property. I'm more keen on vehicles. Traveling, yes. Traveling is my passion. That's one of my biggest goals, that I want to travel the world. At least a few countries. That's one of my major goals in life. I travel a lot, so that's one of my passion and goal. Yep. Anything else, anyone? Yeah, so see, like I linked your project goal to the team goal. Okay, so once you begin your MBA sessions, you may be given a project. Okay, that you need to work on a particular project and submit that project by the end of your term. So that would be team goal. Right?
How to select your team?
Well, it depends. I'm not sure if the college sends your team or you guys are allowed to choose a team. How would you do that? I mean, how would you
select?
No. I'm thinking on the other terms that you want. You have an individual goal and you want your team to help you achieve that. That can be.
Take an example of the political system. Right? This movement thing is to achieve a one dream, that is, Svendhavara.
So how will you convince these people of the creation that you are, you know?
Oh my God, that's politics and I'm not looking for politics at all. I can give you organizational examples. Yeah, so for example, if since I'm working with GDD, okay, right now, and I am part of the learning development team, I want to achieve a certain task of mine, and I would delegate it to a couple of people in my team, or I'll choose a couple of people, make it a team, and drive it, aggressively drive it, if I have to achieve that goal.
You will also, sir, if the, like, in your team, if they're not on the same page, so, like, how will you convince them?
So, see, convincing is something I would not do, but I would definitely talk to them, explain to them why we are doing it. Okay, I really don't want to convince them. I would really, so I have this thing of rapport building, which we spoke about. I have a very good habit of rapport building. Okay, I can build rapport with anyone. I try my best. So, with my rapport, with my connect, okay, I can build rapport with anyone. I try my best. So with my rapport, with my connect, I get it. Since I have a good rapport with people, they will not say no to get them. Because then I will be in turn, I will help them in turn as well, in other aspects of whatever they want. Anything else?
We briefly spoke about communication, briefly spoke about rapport building, connect building. A lot of goal settings. I spoke about prioritizing. That's a little bit of time management as well. Some elements of time management comes when you talk about prioritizing. And you also prioritize your requirements in terms of your goals. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Before we actually end, I actually got up because I wanted to take your attention to these two standees that are kept here. Do you think you can relate these two standees to what Jay spoke about and I also spoke about? Can you see what's there on the standees? Have you observed them while walking in and walking out since you're in that corner? Do you think you can relate them to your goals?
Yes.
Do you think you can convert it into a vision board?
Yes.
How? Sorry?
Study about it, you should know what, like, it's about something that you should get into.
Yeah.
You can study more about that and you can make a start that in this much time I want to be in this position.
Right. Okay. You can make a chart as in you start with this company at this designation and move on to whatever that you want to achieve. And you can also mention the package because it is mentioned right there.
Yes.
Right. But let me give you a very simple vision board which you can build. Right. All of you have computers or laptops or, you know, you can do it on a phone these days. Also, you have a lot of apps to edit. Right. So talk about a vision board. Right. They're very simple things that I have always done. I still do it today, right? Of course, there's time you need to get salary checks. Now you have apps, your banking apps, right? What you do is, whatever amount that you're getting as your salary, I understand you're not getting a salary right now, but I'm sure there are certain transactions. If there are no transactions, you can just pick up an image from internet saying that this is your account. That is where you put your name on the top. Put a random account number, which is okay, but you put your name on the top, and that is where it says that so much amount of salary has been credited. So there is a date and time, let's say March 25 or 24 for you, whatever is your time, right? That month, that year, and the salary that you're looking at, right? That's what. So let's say you want to start at, because it says highest 9 LPA. You want to start with 9, right? You can divide 9 by 12, a very simple math, and that will give you the per month average, right? That is your salary, that is credit, correct? And then, out of all of these, you can, not only these, you can go beyond this, and you can choose a particular organization, where you can write salary credit from, let's say, for example, Infosys, yes, the month, or the date is your choice, when you want, and you can write the amount, let's say 80,000, for example, because that comes close to 9.96. Yes, so that is something that I have in front of me every time, because
because this date, this year, salary credit from Infosys, and then I have the amount. Exactly the vision board that I was talking about. When you wake up in the morning, in fact, you can make your screensaver if you want. Or you can have it as a screensaver for your laptop or desktop. Or if you want to keep it secretive, which is fine, you can have it as a place where you can put desktop. Or if you want to keep it secretive, which is fine, you can have it as a place. Right? Okay. Now, if I have to look at all of this, right, if I have to look at all of this, so many companies, my only top work with, I know this is, you know, you're talking about with multiple companies, it has, you know, got to the candidates or the students placed it. Maybe you can have, again, goal setting, prioritize it, bring it down to the top three of your choice, and this just show that only top three are mentioned here. When I say when only top three are mentioned here, I'm talking about you building exactly this kind of thing, or drawing it, or using any of the apps to create it, right? And also, what you can do is same thing, same format, right? Highest is, okay, I don't know what highest you want to go, you can go up to 10, 20, 30, 40, your choice. Put that number here, write your name here. Saying that, okay, I have got this much salary, which is the highest placement from my college. Yes? And you can enter the top company here that you want to work with. Right? I think you can also do it here. Do you want to see yourself here?
Yes.
How many of you want to see yourselves here? At least in the top 10. Okay, not all of you. Some of you have raised. Some of you, the others, don't want to see themselves here. Okay, for those of you who are really very interested, replace this picture of Costco with your picture. You can do it, you can edit that part. I don't have to tell you how. It's very simple. Right? Write your name, whatever your specialization is. List it, you can write three companies or make it one company depending on your choice. It could be any company, it doesn't have to be companies from here. Right? And write those. Simple? Can that be done? Can that be done? And then, apart from that salary credit from a bank account, you have to be prepared this every day. Trust me, when you will reach your MBA and your placement start, if you are doing this every day and looking at it every day, trust me, whatever company and whatever package you have got will be. And that is one way of imagining that vision board. So vision board becomes a day of the day is, but when people who are looking at that Porsche every day, he wanted it and he actually got it. Or he will get it, which is a good thing. But
nice.
Looking at something, the vision board has actually a lot to do with visualization. You understand visualization? When you imagine something, somebody had mentioned from here, imagination and creativity. When you imagine it and visualize it, you have vision. But you have to set, like Ram was saying in the morning, you have to set smart goals for them. So it has to be specific. You cannot dilly-dally by saying, no, you know, I wanted 10 lines, but now I want 12 lines. Oh no, now the situation is bad because of COVID, so we 12, 10 lines and 8 teacher later. Don't do that. You have a goal, stick to your goal, irrespective of COVID or recession or whatever the situation is. Right? Yeah, does that help? Take a picture of this and create your own. All right, thank you everyone. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am, and Jay sir, on behalf of Neville Wadia, for taking your time and delivering such an interactive and innovative session. The activities were really engaging, and I'm sure everyone enjoyed it as well. Guys, there will be a break for 1 hour, 2:15 actually, 2:15. There are refreshments at the back, and you can also visit the restaurants outside. Okay. Bye. Thank you.